about to leave to go see Johnny Cupcakes. I'm so excited.
I came up with a contest once with these water bottles. Got these Johnny Cupcakes water bottles made. One thing that's difficult about getting custom products made is that you have to get them made in bulk. You have to order a large number of them. We sold a lot of these Johnny Cupcakes water bottles. I still had a lot left. I didn't want to keep putting them on sale because having frequent sales, in my opinion, equals frequent fails, and it just looks tacky. If you have a sale all the time, people are going to stop buying regularly priced products. And then they're going to stop buying products that are on sale because they know they can get it on sale next week. I get emails from a few websites that I used to shop at, and they have a sale every week. And I'm like, all right, this doesn't affect me anymore because I'm now numb to these sales. There's a lot of clever ways to get rid of product. You can still have sales here and there, but not every single week. I thought it would be cool to get rid of these water bottles in a different way. So I thought it would be cool to have a contest. What can you do with a Johnny Cupcakes water bottle besides drink out of it? And if you submit a video showing what you can do, then you have a chance of winning a $500 gift card and some other prizes. But the cool part about this contest is you need a water bottle to even participate. So our sales just skyrocketed through the roof. But people were happy because they got to participate in something, and it worked out for everybody. So that was pretty cool. They had like all these Greek letters printed on the back of their sweatpants. And they all had these North Face jackets on. These one North Face jackets. You can't go to college unless you get the black North Face jacket that's half windproof and half fleece. And they had their Ugg boots on. I was like, all right, cool. Nothing wrong with it. My dad has some Ugg boots, kind of weird, but cool. They're comfy. He likes them. He likes them. I love them. I love my dad. Not the boots, but. Yeah. They came in. They're happy, looking for cupcakes. They leave saying bad words, and they never come back again. And the last example I'll give you is two guys from Berklee School of Music were walking down Newbury Street. They were very stoned, I could tell, because they could barely open their eyes. They were walking super slow, and right when they walked in front of my store, they looked up. They said, cupcakes. I guess it makes you hungry or something, but I'm just kidding. So they went inside the store about 10 hours after they finally got up the stairs. They opened their eyes, and they looked around, and they thought that they had something bad inside of the marijuana that they smoked, because they're in a bakery that doesn't sell food. And they're like, whoa, Johnny Cupcakes, more like Johnny Beefcakes. So for the rest of my life, these guys call me Johnny Beefcakes. Maybe I'll put it on a shirt as a joke and see what happens. But
just came back from the Johnny Cupcakes suitcase, or Johnny Cupcake lecture at the library, and it was awesome. And I got a couple of shirts. I'm gonna show you real quick. That is, it's black, simple black shirt, but that's the front with cupcake and pencils. And then this is the very back. Love it. I'm digging it. Really digging it. And then I also got a regular one with just a black and cupcake and crossbone. So, classic.
Everyone says, why don't you just sell cupcakes? Well, if I sold cupcakes, then people would be happy. And those upset people talk about my business more than the happy people do. As I mentioned earlier, I've spent little to no money on traditional advertising to this day. It's mostly been from people sharing their stories, their experiences, whether they're positive or negative. Anytime those upset people see a bakery, a cupcake, the name Johnny, a t-shirt, a refrigerator, they're likely to share their story about how they went into Johnny Cupcakes. And then their nieces and nephews might be walking by my store saying, hey, isn't that shop that Uncle Frank hates? Let's go check it out and see what's wrong with it. They go inside, they either leave with something or they don't. But no matter what, they leave with an experience and a story to tell. And that's the beauty of creating a business that's unique and that gives people something to talk about.